I'm Catherine. I'm 72 years old. I live in Carlsbad, California, and I have a very huge lump on my arm. It began back in 1989. I lived in New York, and I had ballet subscriptions. This was my last ballet in New York, and I happened to just look down on my arm, and I saw the lump. I guess it was about the size of a peach pit, and then it just started getting bigger. Now it's almost up to my shoulder and armpit. When I first moved out to California, I was an outdoor sit in the sun person. We used to always just hang around the pool, but over the years, when this developed, it made me very self-conscious because people used to say, oh my God, look at that muscle. And I would say, it's not a muscle.
Dr. Lee will be right in, okay?
I don't like having it on my arm. When I look at it, I see this ugly blob. It's gross. I really would like it off. I've seen at least 4 dermatologists on it. All of them have repeatedly said it would be a major surgery. And I think it's scary. I do have what they call the white coat syndrome. It's like whenever you go to a doctor, my blood pressure goes really high. Some kind of psychological fear or something. I don't know. I'm really afraid they're going to see this very high blood pressure and rush me to the emergency room.
Catherine?
Well, hello. How are you?
Oh, I'm fine, Dr. Lee.
Dr.
Hello.
Dr. Lee, it's really nice to meet you outside here.
Pleasure to meet you.
I think I see what you're here for, huh? You got a little friend on your arm.
Yeah,
it's like
I
a little
know.
Boob on your arm, huh?
It's my jelly bean.
How long have you had this?
It started kind of a little bit smaller than this back in 1989. Okay. And this was the start. And over the years,
it's moved up, actually,
it's
huh?
Moved
usually
up.
It's the opposite.
Yeah,
it
only is
yeah you're so
big.
Thin, and yeah, it takes up a lot of space there.
Not sure if I can afford to lose the weight.
With Catherine and her skinny habitus, there are certain challenges that are different.
Looks like a lipoma, but it's pretty big.
Because she doesn't have much fat on her body, it makes it more challenging because you're not sure whether you're removing lipoma or you're removing other fat. I can't be sloppy with this.
The problem is, obviously, the bigger something is, the more complicated it can be to remove,
right?
And, you know, there's more risk involved. And you are so teeny tiny, I have to be really gentle and cautious in this area. But I'm going to give it a try, okay? As you know, you will have a scar here, but we'll try to minimize that as much as we can, and we'll hide it on your inner arm.
I do have the white coat syndrome, but
okay, we'll just make sure you're nice and relaxed, certainly.
Yeah.
White coat syndrome is increased blood pressure and anxiety from a doctor being in the room, but it can actually also occur because you're physically wearing a white coat. I'm not wearing a white coat, so it shouldn't be a problem.
We can give you something to like help relax you a little bit, just to take the edge off, okay?
Sounds good. I'm very excited. I'm a little scared. Now that I'm older, I feel more vulnerable. You know, it's different when you're 40 years old. Yeah, nothing can happen. When you're 70, you can.
Have a seat, and we'll let Dr. Lee know you're here, okay?
Okay. I'm putting my fate in Dr. Lee's hands.
Hi, how are you? Are you chilly in here? It's cold
yes,
in here.
Yes, I know.
We'll get you
cold.
A nice blanket.
Nervous?
Did we give you something, too?
They did. I asked for half a Xanax.
Okay, good. So it'll start kicking in a little bit, but by the time we start, you'll see, you'll be calm, because you'll see that this is it. This is nothing worse than this, you know? It's not bad at all. And I know you're tough, too. So.
Oh, yeah.
In order to keep Catherine's anxieties down, we've decided to give her some anti-anxiety medication. But I'm still going to keep a watchful eye to make sure she stays calm. My secret weapon is to stay as chatty as possible, really distracting her from what we're doing, yet also really making her feel like she knows what's going on.
So what we do is when I numb this, I numb it in a very safe way, actually, and kind of plump it up with a lot of fluid, just salt water, and it's mixed with numbing. So it numbs you, but also it kind of provides a little cushion because it kind of separates this from your muscles, your nerves. You okay?
Yeah, I think so. I'm just trying to calm down.
Okay, we'll give you a few minutes here, too, to get nice and calm, okay?
So my plan for Catherine is to use the tumescent technique for numbing. It's not only gonna bathe the growth and numb it, it's gonna lift it up from deeper structures. And she doesn't really have a lot of natural padding. All she has is this growth and muscle and vessels and bone. So it's really nice to kind of separate them a little bit, put them in their own separate little room. This is very useful in somebody who's so very thin like Catherine is.
All right, so you shouldn't feel anything other than us touching you. You don't have to look or anything. We'll look,
okay? Oh, I don't intend to.
Little baby pinches here, a little pinch.
I can feel that it's numb, but I'm also getting scared.
You doing all right?
Yeah, I feel it.
Feel sharp? I mean, does it hurt, though?
No, I just feel that it's cutting.
Okay, good. I want to make sure I'm not hurting you. That's the whole point.
Oh, so. No, I probably would have jumped.
Yeah, you would jump, probably.
Or the leg would have gone up. That's usually my thing at the dentist, when the leg goes up.
Just gets wet, that's all, because we bathed it in a lovely little bath of saline, of cold saline.
Well, thank goodness.
If I didn't know it was water, I would be, oh my God. It does make your mind go a little crazy. That's why we definitely tell you about those things.
Nobody likes the sight of blood. When I was a kid, I had a nosebleed, and it was a horrible nosebleed because a blood vessel broke. So I couldn't put my head back because I was choking on the clots.
Oh, that's scary.
I hope I'm not talking too much.
No, we want you to talk, because then you know that you're doing all right, right?
And I'm still here.
And you're still breathing.
Yeah.
I love that Catherine is distracted, but I don't think uncontrolled bleeding is the best topic of conversation right now. The good news is that I've been able to tackle a lot of the underside of this lipoma while Catherine's been chatting away. I don't want to be yanking anything besides the lipoma out of here.
You're doing awesome. We almost have it out. I'm just being very, very gentle because you're so thin. You don't have a lot of buffer here. It's almost all teased away.
But you're right. You don't feel it at all.
That's good. That's what I like to hear. Just trying to ease out the last little bit that's tucked under here.
I'm not going to believe this.
You're not going to believe it. You're here. You should believe it. Looks like the shape of Kentucky.
Oh, thank you so much. And my joke was I'd lose 5 pounds if this came off, but I don't think it was a 5 pound.
I think it's going to be more like you're going to lose 5 ounces.
5 ounces?
Yeah, I don't think it's.
It was so, you could play with it. It was so pliable.
Yeah. You can play with something that's 5 ounces. Yeah, you know, it's ounces. Probably like these guys. It's always bigger than they think it is. You know what I mean? Sorry.
Catherine is such a champ. I was able to successfully kick out this Kentucky-shaped lipoma without a hitch.
You want to see what we took? Take a look at your arm.
Oh, my goodness.
So you hit that underneath there, right? You got that sexy arm back.
Oh, my God, I'm looking at my arm. And it's, where the heck did that go, that big, big lump? It's like, it's almost completely flat. My arm is almost completely matching my other arm. It's going to be a pleasure to wear my short sleeve clothes again. I'm excited to dress like summer in the summer.
That looks good, huh? It's going
to... Oh, you thank
you. You look really great.
Now, I can just go out wherever I want. It's going to feel great not having to think twice about where I am and what's on my arms.
It was so nice to meet you. You're an absolute pleasure. You're not nervous anymore, right?
No. Dr. Lee is so patient, so gentle. She has a wonderful way of just helping the patient totally relax. My arm is back to normal. This is life-changing.